What's up, guys? Ryan McNeil, back with another video on my art. Hope you enjoyed the last one, and I think you're gonna enjoy this one just as much. A few more tips on how to be a good artist. It really helps if you have a clear goal in mind for the theme of your work. Something that interests you, that catches your attention on the daily, that's what you wanna draw about. That's what you wanna paint about. It's gotta be something you're passionate about that you can't stop thinking. For me personally, it's outer space, good and evil, heaven and hell, truth and justice, light and dark. I like that kind of stuff. So in all my pictures, you can see some sort of story being painted about those things. But for you, it might be nature. You might be really interested in people or food or families or places. If you like to paint landscape or realism, that's cool too. You gotta find what you really enjoy and then just go after it. But make sure that you're not too worried about making a living off of it. Because at the end of the day, being a successful artist takes hard work and, one might argue, a large amount of luck. But I promise you, if you do put in the work and you do reach out to people and you look for jobs and you look for opportunities, you're gonna find them, and it's just up to you to prove yourself. I'm not a full-time artist. I do this stuff for fun and I keep all my work for myself. I really enjoy looking at it and I find it really inspiring. My full-time career is actually an engineer, and this is what I like to do for fun. A lot of people are shocked to find that you can be good at math and good at art at the same time. I can help, but I've always been extremely outgoing and I just love conquering new skills. I can definitely say that I'm motivated by accomplishment, and my skill in art is one of my most prized possessions. That being said, I work on a lot of other things on the side, but when it comes down to my core of who I am and what I've got to offer, this is without a doubt the one that shines brightest. So as you can see, I've got the shirt that goes with this picture as well. That's because this is also one of the most iconic pictures in my collection. A lot of people show interest in this artwork when they come and they see all of my work. I'm really honored that they like it so much. It started off as something that wasn't that big of a deal to me. It's actually drawn on paper that I dislike with markers and pens that I don't like to use either. This is one of the earliest pictures in my collection. Just like the space painting, it came very early on and I've learned a lot since then, but it's still such a treasure that I would be a fool to put it on the back burner for any reason. So I call this picture the Walk of Life, and it just resembles the path that you take from start to finish and all the things you encounter in between. Now obviously it's one of my paintings, so it has a lot to do with life and death and good and evil, and you can see that all along the path. Now music is key to a lot of different feelings in life, and people listen to different music for all kinds of reasons. That's why I like to show the piano keys. It just shows a nice transition. There's lots of moods, there's lots of feelings, ups and downs, and music brings that to the table. One of the first things you notice again is the location of a little figure that would be none other than me in the bottom corner, and it's climbing up a ladder into the bottom of a grave. Now that grave also is marked with a tombstone with my initials, and there's grass and flowers growing out of it. Now it's not to be taken sad. Even though the flower is crying, it's smiling. That's just to show that even when you're gone, it's not the end of the road and there's so much joy to come that you have no idea. Above the sunflower, you can see that there's three spirits. They are coming out of the creation that you see, the three bands that are coming out. There's so much to this picture that it's really hard to describe to you. So on the right side of the painting, you can see that there's two owls and there's a lake and there's lots of earth texture. There's lots of green and blue, and this is just to resemble being rooted and grounded on earth. And actually, the inspiration of the two owls comes from me and my niece. We used to make a lot of art together, and so you can see that's just kind of an homage to both of us sitting up in my room and making these paintings way back in the day. Courtney, if you're watching, you know that I love you, and this picture definitely reminds me of you every time I see it. So you can see the big yellow figure. One of the most iconic images in this picture is the notorious mushroom man. He has got long hair and a headband, and he seems to be smoking a pipe, and in one color comes out another color. This is just kind of resembling of breathing in something and breathing out something else. He's clearly smoking a pipe. Maybe this is something like a hobbit, right? So thinking about life, taking in one thing, letting out another. I don't know, you take it how you want, but it's definitely a tribute picture and it is what it is. In between, the backdrop of the mushroom man is definitely the moon. I love drawing the moon, I love the craters and the shading, so that is the only time you'll see that I use pencil in my drawing is when I'm shading the moon. And I think it adds a lot of depth to it, and I love to just keep that versatility of multimedia on the painting. You can see where his legs stretch down to the earth. In the gap between the moon and the earth is a space called home, and also that his feet are rooted into the earth, so he's well grounded. Moving your way up the stairs, you see on the left side that the sprites are carrying a lantern, and that's lighting up the day, and that just shows a little bit of the truth being shown. People knowing what's real and what's not. You gotta know what's right. You can't just ignore the light, right? You live in the cave, you never see the light, and you don't make it anywhere, and that's not a good place to be. So I like to live my life outside the cave, seeing what's out there and knowing what's real and know what's good. Now, that being said, the sprites aren't all good, kind of represent the conflictions of the soul. Now, there's three bands that come out of a door that's actually in the center of the drawing. That is where the steps to the keyboard lead up to a door with a lock that is open, and behind that door, you see space, you see stars, And out of that space comes the three color waves, and they're in different patterns. You've got color blotches, you've got stars, and you've got planets. And I like to use in places where I have a lot of color and a lot of different blotches, that's just kind of meant to represent a creation, kind of everything that makes up what we have and what we are and what we see. That's just kind of creation. That's how I put it on page, is by just making a bunch of colors that kind of mingle around each other using organic shapes. Out of the three bands comes the three sprites, and that's just kind of a confliction of the soul. People have things they struggle with, and that's okay. And this is a painting that depicts overcoming those struggles. One thing you might notice is that one actually has a hold of a petal on the flower, and so that's kind of why the flower's got some, like, he's laughing, but he's got tears of joy as well, because making it to the end isn't always painless. Sometimes you suffer loss, but it doesn't really matter in the end, because if your heart's in the right place, your mind's in the right place, you're gonna be just fine. So you can see surrounding the door is the trees, and that's just kind of the last note I wanted to make on this picture. It's a great picture. A lot of people really love it. A lot of people don't get to know the whole story of my art, and that's one of the main reasons that I'm making this YouTube channel and showing off my art in general, because I want people to know. And I don't know, personally, I don't want to take time writing a story and making a website. I know I might do that eventually. I need to, but putting images online is a little bit risky. People could take them. And so I'm just kind of doing what I want right now, showing it off. I want people to see, I want people to know. If you're interested in talking about my art, please feel free to reach out and contact me. We can look at some of the pictures closer up. You know, we can talk about it and give you more details about the art and about the picture and about me, myself. I want to really thank you for watching these videos. I know if you found them and you think they're interesting and you want to see the next one, I'm going to work on it right away. And I'm having a blast. I'm very new to YouTube, so I appreciate you sticking with me. I know it's just like a train wreck of quality, and you know, just bear with me while I get started and I just show these off, and we're gonna talk about more success tips and more finance tips and stuff. I just wanna make sure I do the research. I wanna do the right thing for you guys so that you're entertained and you're well educated, and then I feel like I'm doing my job here on YouTube. So without going any further, I just wanna thank you for watching this. I'm gonna throw some close-up shots of the picture so you can get a really good look at all the different features that we talked about. And again, just thank you so much for watching. I'd love it if you liked or subscribed. And definitely comment down below what you like most about it. And you know, if I was to make another one, what would you like to see me draw? Because that's really where I want to go with this. I think it's going to be awesome. And I love to make art. It takes a long time, but you know, with a little bit of encouragement, anything's possible, right? So again, I'm Ryan. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.